Sky is getting darker and darker, and my camera doesn't know what she should do, if she should stop giving me light or not, and she's getting very confused and I'm getting very blurry, I bet. Hello beautiful bookworms, my name is Katrina and welcome to my channel, and today I have another book review for you guys that, if you can tell, is filmed on the same day that I filmed the other, because I don't have more time to do this, so I just do it when I can. Sorry about that. So today I'm going to be reviewing The English Patient by Michael Ondaatje, and this was one of the books that I read for the Owls Readathon in April, and I have to say that it was one of the books that I have loved most in this year. Obviously I haven't read a lot because I've been reading the Lord of the Rings trilogy, and then I am only now starting to read some different books, but I have to say that this is now one of my favorite classics of all time, and I will proceed to tell you why. So obviously this is a non-spoiler review, so if you haven't read the book or watched the movie, because yes, there is a movie that I haven't watched yet and I want to watch it because now I've read the book, so I can, you know, do you get the excitement? As I was saying, you can still see this video if you haven't read or watched this particular piece of literature or cinema. So The English Patient is basically the story of four main characters, a girl and three men. And basically it's the story of her that is a 20-year-old nurse that is with an English patient completely burnt, in which you don't know his identity because he claims that he doesn't remember it himself, but he speaks perfect English, so you believe that he is indeed English. And she is with him in an Italian house called a villa, in the middle of nowhere, where when the Allied troops retreat from the Second World War. So when everything is won, pretty much, and the war is over. And she refuses to leave him to die alone, so she stays with him in that house. And not soon after that, an ancient family friend of hers and her father comes to that house in search of her, badly wounded and addicted to morphine. And also a bomb detonator Indian guy just appears out of nowhere because he receives a call that there are some bombs or mines inside of the ground in that area, so he goes there to try and destabilize them. And those are the main four characters of this novel. So this novel goes back and forth between the period of 1937, I believe, until the period of 1945, which is, I believe, the actual present period of the novel. So you get the Second World War opinions throughout the four characters, and it is fairly interesting, so it's kind of a historical fiction kind of a book in which you get kind of a novel vibe. So you basically spend a lot of time inside of those four characters' heads, inside of what they feel, inside of what war made them and what traumas they had to go through to think like they think now, and it's fairly amazing. It is a deep study, a deep poetic study into the relationships of these four people and how they see the entire world in four different forms, and how they stick together or how they fall apart, and it's just beautifully done. And you also have the mystery of who is the burnt patient, because you believe that he's English, but he might not be. You never know, because he's completely burnt and he doesn't know his own name, or so he says. So it is fairly beautiful. You have a mystery in there, but you have also an historical fiction about the war. You learn a lot about what brigades were doing what, and you learn a lot about bombs, which was something that I kind of didn't need, but I also liked to read. And for a book that is so deeply character study in a way, it is so fast-paced. Like, I read this in pretty much one day and a half, and it was perfect. It was very poetic, very lyrical, it was beautiful. The characters were really fleshed out. It was amazing to read. It was one of the most beautiful books that I've read in a while, and for me to say this, it is a lot, because books are beautiful in general, but they don't always have beautiful things in such hard topics. So yeah, I really like it. Obviously, trigger warning for those of you that have problems with burnt people, because there is described how he is burnt, and for those of you that have some problem with the World War II, there are some things described in very particular detail. There are no things about the concentration camps, so if you are vulnerable to that sort of thing, you can still read this because there's nothing about that. It's more about the desert and the wars in Africa and everything, and yeah, it goes throughout the entire planet, but not specifically to the concentration camps. So basically, I don't have very much non-spoiler things to say anymore, so yeah. So that is all that I have to say about this book, so if you read The English Patient, please leave a comment down below saying what you felt about it, and yeah, that is all for today, and happy readings to you all. Bye!